In my last videos about the cesium distillation, the cesium preparation, the sodium vapor lamp and the cesium plasma, I'm using a vacuum pump in combination with a vacuum gauge. I got asked by several people what vacuum gauge I'm using, so I thought I would make a short video about it. In this video, I will show you how I built a vacuum gauge controller in a 3D printed housing that has functions that not even the more expensive commercially bought units have. If you search online for a professional vacuum gauge that can measure very low pressures, you will see that they get pretty expensive. You will have to spend around 400 to 500 bucks for a vacuum gauge in combination with a controller. But what you can get pretty cheap is the vacuum gauge itself. You will only buy the vacuum gauge, the cable was cut off in my case, and you will get nothing else, so you have to solder your own cable to it and also use your own connector. This video will mainly be about the vacuum controller you can see on the right hand side and how I built it. The gauge you can see on the left side here is a Pfeiffer PCR260. PCR means that it is a pirani capacitance gauge, so it combines two measuring methods. On the one hand, it uses the pirani method, and on the other hand, it uses the capacitance method. The advantage of this combination is that you can measure pressure in a broader range. The pirani gauge is only capable of measuring a pressure reliably in a range of about 10 to the power of minus 4 to 1 millibar, and the capacitance gauge is able to measure the pressure from 1 millibar upwards, so 1 millibar to around room pressure, so 1000 millibars. The measuring method of a pirani gauge is in theory pretty simple. It is a heated metal wire that is suspended in a gas and will lose heat when a molecule hits it and carries the heat away from it. That means that in a high pressure environment, there are more molecules that are able to hit the wire and carry the heat away, and in a low pressure environment, a vacuum, there are less molecules that can hit the wire and carry the heat away. There are different ways to determine the heat loss. The simplest way would be to determine the resistance of the wire, because the resistance changes with the temperature. Since the thermal conductivity and the heat capacity of the gas affects the readout of the sensor, you have to calibrate your pirani gauge to the gas you want to measure. In our case, that's not a problem, because the gauge I bought is already calibrated for air. The built-in capacitance gauge is also built pretty simple. It is a diaphragm that gets pushed in by the environmental pressure, and depending on the deflection of this membrane, the capacitance changes. The readout of the sensor is pretty simple. It gives out a voltage of around 2.2 to 8.68 volts, depending on the pressure. By using a simple equation, you can use the voltage of the sensor to calculate your pressure. The pressure equals 10 to the power of U minus C. U is the voltage of the sensor, and C is a constant. This constant value determines the unit your pressure will be in. So for example, if you want your pressure in millibar, you would use a C of 5.5. If you want your pressure in torr, you would use a C of 5.625. To read out the voltage of the sensor and display the pressure, I'm using an Arduino. You could simply use the onboard ADC from the Arduino itself, but since the analog digital converter of the Arduino has only 8 bits, the resolution would be pretty low. Normally that wouldn't be a big deal, but because the equation we are using to calculate the pressure is a logarithmic function, even small changes in the voltage will result in a huge change in pressure. For that reason, I'm using an external analog digital converter. It is the ADS1115 and it has a 16-bit resolution. Since the ADC can only take up to 5 volts and the voltage of the sensor can reach up to 8.7 volts, I'm using a voltage divider to divide the voltage by 2. I'm compensating for that division in software by just multiplying the voltage readout with 2. The pinout of the sensor is pretty simple. You basically have 5 pins you have to worry about. It is the signal output, the signal common, the supply, and the supply common. You can use different power supplies to supply the sensor. The sensor accepts 15 to 30 volts DC, but the voltage should of course be constant. So you simply connect your power supply to pin 4 and 5. After that, you can use pin 2 and 3 and connect them to your ADC to read out the voltage of the sensor. If you just want to display the pressure on your 16x2 LCD display, you can just use an Arduino Uno. In my case, I had to use an Arduino Mega because I wanted to display the pressure as a graph on a TFT display. You really don't need the graph on the TFT display, but I thought it would look cool, so why not? After I wrote the code for the pressure readout and the LCD display, I thought it would be an easy job to get the code for the graph on the TFT display to work, but it turned out it wasn't that easy and I had to get a little bit of outside help to get it running. Another great feature of this controller is that you can use a USB cable to connect it to your PC and use the serial print function to plot the pressure against time in, for example, Excel. Here you can see the code I wrote for the LCD display. I'm just reading the voltage from the ADC, and true voltage is my volts times 2 because I use the voltage divider to divide the voltage by half. In the next step, I'm calculating the pressure in two different units. In the first case, I'm calculating the pressure in millibar. That means I'm calculating 10 to the power of true voltage minus 5.5. After that, I'm using the serial print function and the LCD print function to send the pressure to my LCD display. In the next case, I'm just calculating the pressure in torr and sending it to the LCD display. That means that you can simply change the unit to whatever unit you want by changing the constant in the software. If you have any questions regarding this project, if I forgot to explain something you are interested in, or if you have criticism or suggestions how to improve this project, I would love to read a comment from you. I read them all and I'm glad if I can help.